Welcome to Honey and Brown.
Welcome. What do we do here?
We do anime and music.
Today?
We are doing anime. Kotaro Lives Alone. Oh my god.
Episode 7. Sorry, it's been a while since we uploaded for Kotaro. It's such a beautiful anime. One of the best animes I've seen. Yeah, phenomenal.
Honestly, like, it's... I want to put it in my top 5, but my top 5 is, like, fully booked. So it's in my top 6.
Yeah.
But I love this anime so much.
So far, it's been a very heartbreaking, heart-wrenching, tragic show. Like, it's been every single episode has just like hit my heart, and it's hurting so much. But yeah. I'm very excited to get to this. But before we start, so again, thank you guys for watching, subscribing, supporting. You know, a lot of our Kotaro ones. Like, we have people out there that actually like watch this anime. You know, and like look forward to it. And we're so sorry that's taken us so long to finish. But
and I'm so happy for everyone supporting Kotaro. Like, this anime really deserves it.
It does. We do have a playlist of our previous reactions that will be in the description and in the pinned comment. But yeah, thank you guys again for all your support, for commenting, liking. You know, we hit 1,000 subscribers, and it's due to like everybody that's been supporting us on this channel. So we're so grateful, so thankful. Yeah, thank you guys so much. But yeah, let's get on to it. This is Kotaro Lives Alone, episode 7.
Kotaro. Anna? I'm coming over to play at your house after school today, okay?
You are?
Oh, Karino? Nice to meet you.
Man, it's been so long since we watched this.
I'm Kana's mom. Nice to meet you too.
Love interest?
Kana wanted to know if she could play at Kotaro's house this afternoon. Would that be all right?
Oh, well,
this is like ordering Kotaro around. What'd he say?
Great.
I'm coming.
I'll pick her up later. Kana, I'll see you tonight. Be good, okay?
This awkward silence.
Yeah, what's going on here?
So, you two like hang out a lot together?
Not really.
Okay.
But I guess being in the same class means we're friends. Kotaro, tell me, what kind of games do you have at your house?
Would you like to play inside or outside?
Inside.
Such a gentleman.
Play outside today.
I know.
Why did Kana even want to come over here to play?
Man. Yeah.
Why are you sitting here with us instead of going home?
Well,
she's Kotaro.
I decided to leave you guys in my care for the day. So, is there like a game you two want to play?
Yeah, Kotaro hasn't really like talked to a girl like his age, eh?
I know.
How about a game of cards then?
And they're so kind of the same. They seem the same.
Sort of, yeah. Oh yeah, I guess so. Like the way they talk.
Yeah.
Kana asked if she could come over again today. Is that okay?
What?
Splendid.
What do they do though?
Kotaro, I hope you've planned something more fun to do today. You played old maid for hours. I've never been so bored playing cards in my life.
That's right. There isn't really anything fun to do at your apartment, Kotaro. I was pretty bored.
Wow.
She's calling you out.
Bored? Well, I will admit, adult women always find me more captivating than girls my age.
Leave Kotaro alone, man. Man's been through enough.
Kana says she wants to play again today.
Kana's so bored playing with Kotaro.
Yes.
I don't get why she keeps asking to come over.
That's true.
Kana, I do not mind your company in the least. However, wouldn't you have a lot more fun if you were to go over to your actual friend's houses? You're quite popular in school. I've seen you play with many of our classmates during recess.
She smiles a lot.
But I don't mind playing with you also.
Maybe she has like that fake smile, eh?
Oh.
Kana, I'll see you tonight. Be good, okay?
Have you heard yet? Kana's dad lost his job and they had to sell the house.
Aw.
I can't even imagine. That poor kid.
Oh, that's why.
Hey, Miss Sawaguchi. Do you have a talk?
Maybe it's like babysitting or something.
Here's the thing. I don't think Kana should come over to play anymore. You've been making her come over here because you're afraid her friends' families are better off than yours, and you don't want her to see that.
Oh, maybe.
And if that's the case, what does that say about how you view Kotaro?
Wow.
He's just a kid, trying to do the best with his living situation. Maybe you shouldn't take advantage of that.
So, I don't know anything. I wasn't trying to hurt him. I honestly thought it was a win-win. I mean, he doesn't seem to have a lot of friends.
Maybe that's the way he likes it.
Well, you thought wrong.
He has friends.
Next time, you'll think a little harder.
So she thinks Kotaro's beneath her? Wow.
It makes me angry.
Hey, Kana. Do you like playing at Kotaro's house?
No, not really. But it's okay. Because you seem happy when I play at his house. Mama, I don't mind playing with him for you.
Kotaro's not someone you just use.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Huh? I'm so sorry, Kana.
Jugoroku game. Now Kana cannot say he's born in my house.
You are either very noble or very dumb.
a bit of column A, a bit of column B.
He's training.
It's important to start the day right. Make me strong. Why don't I call your mom to pick you up?
I like how Kotaro always has a sword with him.
More than anyone else I know.
Yeah, he got a fever yesterday. Bento, so you'll feel better.
Aww.
Here. It is imperative that you get your daily vitamins in order to stay healthy. Understand? You need to become stronger. You won't keep getting colds all of the time.
That's all he cares about, is just getting stronger because he feels that's the only way to be loved.
Yeah. Kotaro, are you okay? You don't look so
good. Oh, now he's sick.
You're playing, my dear lady. I am a pillar of health.
Oh my god.
Oh, your forehead's burning up.
I am not sick, I tell you.
Because he doesn't want to be weak.
Calm down.
Yeah.
Excited might make it worse.
I'm not sick.
Aww.
Ugh.
Thanks for coming.
My body isn't as strong as everyone else's.
Mm-hmm.
It's easier for me to get sick. I think it's worse to get all of my friends sick than it is to let them think what they want about me. That's why I always say when I feel sick.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay to be weak.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It was wrong of me to assume that you were. You, sir, are very strong.
Thank you.
You need the whole box?
If I want to heal quickly, I'll need all the vitamins I can get.
Oh, Jesus. Take your vitamin C.
You're the most perfect one on the market today. But I was nervous to
She's like,
showing alone.
Yelling.
And then I thought about you. You know so
Lady, it's 8 in the morning.
With me.
Lady Kobayashi, please, there is no need to yell on this. If that is the case, I would be willing to help you out.
To really get a feel for this space, right? TV and table, a futon and pillows for the
bathroom. Oh my god.
A full bath set to test out the bathroom. Using props is a great way to get a feel for a space. It helps me envision this place as my home.
She's so weird.
You like it?
Aye, it's a decent home.
At 305.
Wonder if that's his old place?
Yes. Is the apartment where Kotaro and his parents used to live.
I knew it.
Lady Kobayashi.
Wow.
Did you by chance read the journal entries written to my benefactor?
Yeah, I did. I'm sorry. Please don't be mad.
Why?
Kobayashi, there are probably a lot more painful memories for Kotaro in that house than there are good ones.
Yeah, why would you bring him back there?
You know that, right?
I did think about that. But...
it would be nice to know the house that we called home was still flourishing.
Wow. Look at him. That's where he spent his first couple of years, you know?
Yes.
Was it just for him to, like, cope with what happened in the house, or what?
Hey, are you
I don't know.
I find them to be abundant in this area.
What? These are the only ones I have that fit. It isn't like... I've got money to buy new ones.
Oh, look at him. Even his clothes are too short for him.
That's why you're eating leaves.
I am not without money, but I find I can save on food costs this way.
He's eating leaves, man.
Mom made you come out here too?
Oh.
She did not. I reside in my own apartment.
Oh, did he leave them?
I don't think so.
If we stay here any longer, it will become too dark to see. I wonder, do you know how to get home?
I'm not sure. I don't think so. Did he?
Look. Wow.
What the hell?
We just like went and got food. Oh, maybe he just wanted something for himself. Man, this is like tragic. This is holy crap.
Listen, mommy won't be living with you and daddy anymore.
Just left them?
Where are you going, mommy?
Mommy's. I'm not going to be able to take care of you anymore. You'll have to take care of yourself now. Be strong, and we'll be together again one day.
She just left them?
Told me their parents hadn't come home in months. What kind of a parent just abandons their children?
That's what happened to Kotaro, eh?
They were not abandoned.
Like, he refuses to accept that, eh? That he was abandoned.
You're gonna damage your futon hitting it like that.
Wonderful observation. Good morrow to you, sir.
You sure have a lot of energy. What's gotten into you today?
I've decided to live my life with gusto.
Simply thank you for the other day.
Sorry for the wait. Here, green tea.
Karen is always there.
Yeah.
Green tea is the best compliment to sweet treats.
Right? Japanese treat always goes best with green tea.
I concur.
Kari, no good, sir. You're once again in my room, uninvited.
You literally just said that.
I do look after you all the time, so don't you think I've earned some treats at least?
I never once requested, nor do I need your guardianship.
Wow. Come on, Kotaro.
It is a lot of food for just us. Maybe it wouldn't be so bad if Karino stuck around.
Yeah, exactly.
Perhaps I will bring a plate to search on it.
That's a good idea. What do you want to bet he'll freak out and cry tears of joy?
That sounds about right.
Oh, it's a movie. That sounds like Kotaro.
I know.
Nice. Aww. Why?
Kotaro, I bet you can't wait to see it.
Careful with that. You're gonna poke your eye out.
Become strong.
Hey, watch it.
Strength is like a very important part of this show, hey?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Is that her ex? I'm assuming?
Oh, hey, you're back, Kotaro.
Oh. Lady Mizuki, may I ask what just happened to your cheek?
Cheek?
You always see right through me, Kotaro.
What?
He hit her?
I told him that I didn't want to see him anymore, but I guess he didn't like that.
Your safest option is to leave here immediately, quit your job, and go somewhere where he cannot find you.
But that's what he did.
I said that I would stay here and live with you.
Like I said before, I think that the best option is to just let me handle this guy.
I think we need to report him to the police.
None of you understand. You need to get away quickly before things escalate any further.
So, I'm thinking Kotaro's father abused the mom. And that's why the mom left, maybe?
Yes.
Yeah.
Kotaro?
What is he doing?
He's checking, I think.
Like every 10 minutes?
Kotaro! So is this your plan? Keep pestering me till I move? You want me gone that bad? Look, I'm gonna try to go to the police like Karino suggested. Then I won't have to move.
Listen to me, my lady. You do not want to be the reason someone you love becomes a bad guy. I I could be mistaken, but it seems to me you still love your boyfriend. I agree, you do need to break up with him. But you don't want to make things worse than they already are. I know this, because I turned my father into a bad guy.
Oh.
Lady Mizuki, do not make the same mistakes that I did.
So maybe the father didn't want him?
It's so hard. It wasn't all bad. There were good times too.
I know. It's never easy.
Did he actually move? Oh my god, she's moving.
Thank you. Well,
she needs to move on, right? Yo, why are you wearing a mask? He doesn't want to show his emotion. Oh, Kotaro.
I don't think you should blame yourself for what happened to your father. In the long run, who knows, maybe something good will come out of it. I did call the police in the end, and it was your strength that helped me do that.
Wait, so you don't need to leave then?
Well, there wasn't enough evidence to arrest him, so he could still come looking for me. It's just safer for everyone if I go.
I'm so sad Mizuki's leaving.
I'm so sorry, Kotaro.
I know, I don't think they'll ever see each other again.
I promised we'd be together forever.
Oh.
I remember. No such promise.
She's always like a mother to him almost, you know? Or like an older sister or something. Like always took care of him, always very sensitive to his need, yeah. Never got bored of him, always, you know?
Yeah, bring him snacks.
Thank you for everything. I love you.
Oh man.
You can take that silly mask off. No one here is gonna judge you if you're crying right now.
You are mistaken.
You know if you need a hug, I'm here for
unnecessary.
You.
Unnecessary.
Unnecessary. Aw, look, he's still holding on to them, though.
Yeah.
You're so stubborn. He's headstrong.
All right. As you can see, she's like bawling her eyes out. Oh my god, that was... Jesus, that was such a... As I keep saying, every single episode just gets more sad and sad and sad. And now you're starting to see, you know, the history of Kotaro. But what were your thoughts on the episode?
all I keep thinking in that moment when Mizuki was saying goodbye. Like when she said, like, you know, I guess I can't keep the promise that we'll be together forever. All I keep thinking was the time that Kotaro asked, like, told her that if I keep coming to the bar, if I keep selecting you, then that means I can be with you every day. And now he can't. It just breaks my heart. It doesn't seem like they're gonna see each other again.
No, I mean, she needed to like move on with her life, you know. But yeah, this whole episode was more about like strength and finding strength and like that weakness is not weakness in like a negative aspect. That it's okay to like feel. It's okay to break down, right? But yeah, you can tell with Kotaro that strength is very important to him, because now we are getting. More, we are now seeing into the window of Kotaro's heart, right? I'm going on the assumption that his father was abusing the mom and the mom left. I mean, I don't know. Why would the mom leave still? Because, I don't know. And then we come to meet these three new people, and they're abandoned by their own parents. And, you know, they're talking to Kotaro, and, you know, They're telling Kotaro, we are abandoned just like you. And Kotaro's like, I'm not abandoned. I don't think he wants to accept that he's abandoned. I think in his mind, he wants to accept that he needed to leave to get stronger and finding the hope to come back and maybe see his mom or dad to show how strong he was. And I don't think he knows that his mom passed away, right?
No.
I don't think so. So
he still thinks that his mom is coming back.
Oh, yeah, because mom left.
And then his mom told him, like, you know, keep moving one step at a time, or, like, keep moving forward.
Yeah.
Something like that. And it's just, like, it's so heartbreaking because, like, that is what he's doing.
Yeah.
And he's doing it, like, you know.
At 5 years old.
Yeah. He, like, what his mom told him to do, he is doing it. And you know, he's still doing it, and he's not, like, thinking anything badly. Mm-hmm. And even with his dad, like, he doesn't think of his dad as, like, you know, a monster or someone who hurt him. He thinks of him as, like, he blames himself that he made him do bad things. That because of him, he got triggered to do bad things.
Yeah, and we still don't know what happened in that family. And it was really sad when he went back to his childhood home. I don't know what the point of that was. I mean, I don't think Kotaro is ready to handle that type of emotional impact to go back to the house that he called home, you know, the place that he had a mom and dad. And now look where he is now, living in an apartment by himself at 5 years old. You know, at 5 years old, that's incredible to me. This is that's a time where you need your parents, and you need someone to take care of you, to cook you, you know, food, and to walk you to school and to tuck you in. And he doesn't have that. And he's still a kid. I know he's a lot more mature because he's had to be mature.
Yeah.
But you just see him in this episode, and you see the cracks in the foundation now with him. I think he's starting to break a bit. He's starting to open up more, and you're starting to realize that something bad happened in his life, you know, with his parents. And, you know, we're, what, 2 or 3 episodes from the end. So we are getting closer to finding out what really happened. And, you know, we still don't know how the mom passed away. I mean, it had to be from a medical condition, or maybe it was something else. You know, maybe, I don't know. I don't want to speculate because I want to watch it. But, you know, I don't think this is going to have a happy ending at all. Because the last couple of episodes have been, like, very, very hard to watch.
I just hope that there will be a happy ending for Kotaro, at least. Mm-hmm. It breaks my heart so much that, you know, Mizuki left. Mm-hmm. Like, I can't. Like, Kotaro, like, they always play together. Yeah. Whenever they're sweets, it's always with Mizuki. Yeah. And then Karino will just, like, you know, jump into the bandwagon.
And she's always the one to understand Kotaro, like, why he's acting the way he's acting, you know, to the other two gentlemen. They're always very kind of surface level when it comes to Kotaro. For the most part, she understands the pain behind Kotaro's eyes, and she's always the one to come to his defense and explain to other people, almost like she's protecting him from other people, from him being judged in a very negative aspect.
I know, like, you know, remember the time of, like, when he didn't go to, like, the bathhouse?
Oh, right, yeah.
And then, like, Karino kind of said something insensitive that, who cares if you're, you know, if you're dirty? It's like, it's not, you know, like, it's not a big deal. And then, like, Mizuki said, like, oh, maybe, you know, think before you speak.
Yeah, like, there's a reason behind why he's acting like this.
Yeah.
And maybe in his mind's eye that, you know, if he's dirty, no one's gonna want him. Like, she always understood him, but she never like, even though she understood him, she never looked down on him. She always understood, and she always put herself in his shoes, and she always loved him more. Right? I don't know. I think she was more of like a mother figure, maybe like an older sister figure to him, but she took care of him. She understood him. She understood the emotional and psyche side of Kotaro. But yeah, she's gonna be missed, and I hope, you know, maybe in the last episode they will meet up again. I don't know. She needed to go right now to move on with her life.
I don't think, like, it's moving on. I don't know. I don't think it's, like, moving on from her life. Like, she's not moving on from Kotaro.
No, but I think she's moving on so that she can finally, you know, leave her boyfriend and, you know,
like,
I don't know.
Leave the toxic people in her life, maybe.
Yeah. So she's moving on from, from the place. Yeah. I mean, she has her friends there, but that's not going to be forever. I don't know.
I understand. It's just, I can't. Like, all I keep thinking now is all the times that they spent together. Mm-hmm. Like, when they were in the park, like, you know, with the ice cream, trying to take, you know, tried to take Kotaro's pictures.
I mean, their first encounter was, you know, she was drunk and Kotaro was tending to her, you know, and I think Kotaro has experience with that, you know, tending to someone who's passed out on the floor drunk. I guess we'll find out. But yeah, this is a very another emotional episode. Very emotional for this one here. Goddamn. But thank you guys so much again. We're going to try and be more frequent with the last two episodes. And then
last three episodes, guys. Is it going to break us? Oh, my God. Oh, yeah. It's going to break me, I think.
Don't tell us like any spoilers if you've seen it. Don't. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Again, we have a playlist in the description and in the pinned comment of our previous Kotaro Lives Alone reactions. Yes. We also have one for Spy Family. We have one for Attack on Titan. Mm-hmm. We're going to be starting Made in Abyss in the next, maybe in the next month. Maybe the next couple of weeks, once we finish Kotaro Lives Alone, we're going to immediately start Made in Abyss. But thank you guys so much for watching, supporting us, getting us to 1,000 subscribers. We're so grateful. We're so thankful to every single one of you. And yeah, we'll see you in the next video.
See you.